Mr. John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you. As you guys can see, I'm here in the house, actually, not even in the garden. Now you know why I'm in the garden so much. I mean, this is my desk. This is where I work at every day. It's a mess, man, but you know what they say? A messy desk is a sign of a genius. Anyways, I like the garden better. It's a lot more organized and looking neat and got a lot of food growing, too. In any case, we're going to have a fun episode for you guys today. Why I'm inside is because I want to share with you guys a really cool website that you want to be aware about if you're a gardener, especially if you love chilies. Let's go ahead and check it out on my dual screen set. I've got my growing your greens up here, checking it out. And then we're going to go over here and we're just going to type in chiliplants.com. And now we got the website for chiliplants.com coming up here. And what chiliplants.com does is that they sell over 500 varieties of different chili plants and also the seeds. They also offer tomatoes and eggplants, a lot of different rare varieties that you may not be able to find near you. Now at this point, you know, if you're going to have a garden this season, and I encourage everybody out there watching to have a garden this season, and it's never too late to have a garden, right? It's probably a little bit too late for most parts of the country right now to start tomatoes, eggplants, and peppers from seed, you know, unless you live in a place like South Florida or something. You know, so that's why I recommend, you know, especially if you're late to the game, you know, pay a little bit of extra money and buy some plants. I always encourage you guys to buy and start your own seeds whenever possible. It's going to be the cheapest way to do it, and you're going to get the widest variety, because it's quite unfortunate that most places people would buy their plants at, including their local big box store, local nurseries, they have a small limited a selection of plants that you can choose from. So that's the you know, reason for this episode. Chiliplants.com has over 500 varieties of different chili plants that you can purchase, and they could ship you the whole plant even this late in the game right now, so that you could still grow some cool, amazing, and unique varieties of peppers. One of the things I like about their site is number one, they show their top sellers, including the chilies, the sweet peppers, tomatoes, and all this kind of stuff, so you can see what's really popular. Looks like the Smoking Ed's Carolina Reaper is the best seller on there right now, and that's the Guinness Book of World Records holder for the world's hottest chili. And you could, yes, still get the plants and they could ship it out to you. So what we're going to do is actually on this sidebar here, they got a live chili pepper plant search. For me, I kind of like the mild and, you know, mildly spicy chilies. I don't like the super hot ones, man. Although I do like ones with a good fruity flavor, because chilies and hot peppers are not all about just hot that blow up your mouth, right? There's so many different kinds and flavor variations. I mean, so many more flavor variations in chilies than even in tomatoes, believe it or not. And I have a really good video entitled 10 Reasons of Why You Should Grow More Peppers Instead of Tomatoes. In any case, on this side search here, you could get a heat level of sweet, medium, mild, hot. I'm gonna probably stick to sweet, mild, and medium for most of my guys, and then we can check out for all uses. You know, I don't really care about the all uses. The flesh, thin, medium, thick, I don't really care. Length, actually, I kind of like, you know, not super small peppers, but smaller peppers in general. I find that the smaller peppers tend to yield more fruit per plant. You know, I'd rather have, I don't know, 30 small peppers than like two large ones, right? It's a lot more useful for me, in my opinion. Plus the smaller ones ripen up faster, which means you'll be eating sooner out of your garden. So let's see here. So I'm gonna probably stick underneath, you know, I don't know, maybe around 2 to 3 inches, 3 to 4 max. Orientation, what orientation are you? All right, so they have upright pods and pension pods. I don't really care about the orientation of the peppers, although I do care about the orientation of the girls I date. All right. Heights, they talk about the heights of the plants, how tall they can get, if you need to have some smaller plants. All seasons, like how soon they'll ripen up. They have peppers that'll be basically ready in 120 days, you know. I like instant gratification, man, so I'm going to look for like mostly early and mid-season plants, so I'll be eating peppers sooner rather than later. Although you may want to get some plants that, you know, ripen early and then ripen later, so you could stagger your peppers to be able to have time to use them all. All right, and then finally, they got species, so they got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different species of the capsicums. Did you know there's that many species? I mean, most people just think of peppers, it's all the same thing, but there's different ones. I like the pubescent ones. Now, why is that? Because they got pubes. No, they got little hairs on them. I like that a lot, actually. They're some of my favorite ones from South America. And then you could check ones, obviously, that are in stock. So yeah, we're gonna run a couple searches here. Let's get some sweet ones. and see what it comes up as. Here's one, it's called the Day Till Sweet. We're gonna click on that, and I like that they have a nice picture of the pepper so you can see what it looks like, and then they have a little description. The Day Till Sweet says, sweet 1.5 to 2 inches long by 0.75 to 1 inches wide, medium thick flesh, matures from pale green to orange to red, penchant pods, green leaves, 24 to 30 inches tall, late season, 80 to 90 days uses, prolific seasoning pepper, smoky flavor of Day Till without the heat. So yes, that sounds like what I want. We're gonna go ahead and add it to my cart. Man, I could spend hours and hours just researching all the peppers and going through the different kinds, the sweet, the mild, the medium. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and get on here. Oh man, my favorites, the Aji Dulces and the Aji peppers just came up. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish up my order. I'm probably gonna order a bunch of plants from Chili Plants because I was late and neglectful and didn't start my seeds on time because I've been too busy traveling around making video for you guys and just trying to live my life. So I think it's great that they have this resource available, and their plants are basically $3.75 each. So I mean, if you go to your local big box store, plants are like $3 for chili, but in this way you get some plants that are actually a lot more diverse than what you can get locally. It's about the same price. Of course, you got to pay for some shipping, and depending on where you live, that can get a little bit pricey. In many cases, they may ship it second day air to get to you in one piece because plants don't like being tied up in a box, you know, for weeks on end without any sunlight. In any case, we'll go ahead and order a bunch of plants, and then we're going to come back at you once the UPS truck delivers the plants, and we're going to go ahead and unbox the plants, share with you guys what I got, how they look, you know, and if all the plants survive the shipment, and also my further comments about chiliplants.com once I get the plants. Just got my shipment from the UPS guy. Here it is, man. This side up. Hopefully they had it this side up. It's quite important. Uh-oh. Maybe it's not this side up. Maybe it's not this side up this way. Maybe it's this side up this way. Uh-oh. I hope this is all right, and I hope it was transported like this. I guess the next thing is let's bring these to the backyard and check out my babies. So the first thing you do after you get your box is bring it to where you're gonna plant them and open them up immediately. I mean, do not even go to the bathroom once you get these guys. We need to get these guys out of here, because think about it. These guys have been on a cross-country flight for the last 2 days. That means they've been in the dark. It's been perpetual night. I wouldn't appreciate a perpetual night, and unless you guys live in Alaska, you probably wouldn't either. Let's go ahead and open these guys up, and once again, open up on the top side up. And let's see what we got. All right. Man, check it out. These guys are actually doing fairly well. They made the cross-country flight. Check it out. Wow. These guys are packed fairly well inside here. Oh, this guy is empty. Oh, check it out, man. They got their packing down. This packing stuff is really cool. Let's see how we're gonna actually get these guys out. Wow, check it out, man. This is the optimal way to like pack stuff. So even if it's like turned on its side, the soil doesn't come out and they're still cool. So what I'm gonna carefully do is just take my my knife here and carefully cut off the tape and carefully slide these babies out. All right, my first plant I got. Oh, we got more packing material. Check it out, man. They're packing this stuff quite good here. This is the yellow currant tomato right here. Looks like it's made it cross-country trip fairly well, in good shape. Now the main thing is, I know you guys might be excited. John, I just cut my plants, man. I got my raised bed ready to go. I'm gonna plant them right in there. Bad idea. You know, these guys have been in the dark. They've been in who knows what kind of warehouse, what kind of UPS trucks, or what kind of airplanes, and what kind of temperatures they've been exposed to. And if we put them in the sun and direct full hot sun immediately, they're gonna probably go into transplant shock. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually pull these guys out, put them in some flats, and then set them in this little area of my garden, which is actually a raised bed underneath the tree in the shade, where I have some other plants currently waiting. And they're kind of like getting adjusted to the weather here, because these ones were also brought here by car. And then once a day, I'll usually bring them out into the sunlight for like an hour or two. you know, just to kind of get some sun. Like if we were sun tanning, right, you don't want to sun tan and stay out in the sun all day long. You'll get burned, especially at the beginning of the season, right? But if you go out an hour a day, as time goes on, you could kind of like stay in the sun a little bit longer without getting burnt, right? Well, unless you're fair or white skinned. So that's what we're going to do with the plants, right? We need to what's called harden our plants off. We're going to leave them in the shade, let them get acclimated, number one, to the new weather, the light, and then also bring them out into the sun a little bit each day, and then put them back in the shade. And probably about after a couple, 3, 4, 5 days, you know, I'm going to sense the plant, we'll plant them out. After I get these guys out, I'm probably going to give them and hit them with some water and some nutrients if they're dry. This guy feels a little bit dry. You do not want to drench these guys because they can drown. You know, but I'm going to have to check the other ones to see if they're going to need water too, and we'll be back at you once I got all these guys unpacked. So as you guys can see, I got these guys all out of the boxes and put them into little flats here that hold like 16 plants each. I got a total of 66 plants, so all my plants that I ordered were shipped to me, including this one here, the hottest pep in the world. It's called Smokin' Ed's, what is it called? Smokin' Ed's Carolina Reaper. Has a little red tag. Hottest pepper in the world by the Guinness Book of World Records. I'm gonna be growing it now. So after unpacking all these guys, I've noticed that some of them are actually a fair bit wet, so they probably don't need water. But there are a few actually that were a fair bit dry. So after I get these guys put in the shade here underneath my nice shady tree, we're gonna go ahead and water them. And you know, I stuck these in these specific flats here that actually have spacing in between because I wanted to give them some air space. Normally you might want to stick them in a regular flat, but that would crunch them all up. And you know, I wanted to give these guys some space to breathe. These are my eggplants and my tomatoes, and they got actually a little bit drier than the peppers did. What we're going to do next is actually we're going to go ahead and water my plants because some of them were dry, and we're not going to overhead water them because if you overhead water them, you could get some leaf burn, leaf damage. Plus these plants came out of a box and I don't want to stress them out any more than they are. So I'm just going to give them some water with some added nutrition. And what I've done was I've brewed some Boogie Brew compost tea in anticipation of them arriving. And so I've filled up my little sprayer here with half water, and I'm using the half compost tea that I'm pouring through a heavy harvest bag. This has a fine mesh because I don't want any particulate going in to my hose sprayer because I may clog it up. All right, looks like we're full. Go ahead and screw this guy on. Pressurize! Now we're just gonna go ahead and spray down each little plant just a little bit at a time. Oops. Just a little bit at the bottom just to give it a little bit of nutrition and a little bit of moisture. Some are gonna get a little bit more water than others if they're drier. Some's gonna get a little bit less if they're already moist. So as you guys can see, we're back. I hardened off my plants outside, gave them a little bit of sun and water every day because it's been actually drying out pretty fast here in the nice weather, man. Some of the days actually hit 90 in the last week. It's been almost a week now, so I've hardened my plants off. They're getting used to the environment and they're doing well, and I didn't want to keep them in their little pots, you know, any longer than absolutely necessary. I always want to encourage you guys, no matter where you get your plants, whether it's from chiliplants.com or a local nursery, you know, only keep them in the pot as long as you need to before you actually plant them in the ground. Plants don't like being in a pot. You wouldn't like being in a jail cell if you're in jail because there's not a lot of room to move. And kind of like that, that's like the plants in the pots, right? They don't got a lot of room to move. So I want to get them in the bed so that their roots can spread out and that they could start producing some food for me sooner rather than later. In any case, I want to give you guys the update. These guys are all doing quite well. I hit them with the compost tea. And I want to pull this out for you guys, just as one I grabbed, actually. This app happens to be Ahi Panica Chile. And so I just basically watered these guys before transplanting, so it's kind of moist. And we're just squeezing these guys out. And I like that they have every plant tagged well. And this is in the perfect state right now. These guys are shipping. They're not super root bound in the plastic containers. The roots are just starting to get down to where they need to be. And I'm gonna put some mycorrhizal fungi on these guys before I plant them out. I've actually systematically staked out with my template, that'll be another video. All the different places where I'm gonna plant these with a little bamboo stake. It's, you know, I go by the square foot gardening method, which they recommend one plant per square foot. Due to the size constraints, I think I have it around 11.25 inches in between each plant. So that means I'm gonna fit 17 down each row, and I got four rows. I guess we'll be back at you in a little bit once I get this fully planted out, and then I'll share my overall comments about the chiliplants.com peppers and actually other plants that I received from them. So as you guys can see, I pretty much got this whole bed planted out, but it's actually not with my chiliplants.com plants. It's with mostly Bonnie plants, some local nursery plants, and actually a few burpee plants. Yeah, but I had one of them lose their life right here, and as luck would have it, I have one extra chiliplants.com plant that I'm going to plant here in the corner. And I wanted to show you guys this. I mean, this is like pretty impressive. Like, I planted all these guys out. I've planted over 100 pepper plants in my garden so far this year. This is actually probably the last one I got to plant. And I definitely have to say that the roots in this guy, you know, and all these guys have been right about at the right point that I like to plant them. They're not super, you know, crowded and compacted in there and root bound, but they're not too undeveloped either. They're at the right point where if you unpot them, plant it up, it's gonna take right in the ground, start spreading some roots, and start growing some peppers for you. I do also want to say that, you know, I did plant a lot of these Bonnie plants and whatnot, and you know, in my opinion, the health of these guys has actually been a little bit better than some of the Bonnies, in my opinion. And it's probably down to, you know, what they feed these plants. They grow these plants organically. They feed them like a kelp solution, which I'm a big fan of. You know, I don't know what kind of fertilizers and nutrients are given the Bonnie plants. They might be fast-acting fertilizers, so they look nice now, but maybe don't do so well later. Any case, let's go ahead and unpot this guy for you guys. Let's see here. We're just going to go ahead and tap carefully. And check it out. You can see the roots on there. This is not, you know, totally root-bound or anything, but this looks like just enough roots to be established. We're going to go ahead and not even really have to separate these out too much, because these roots are now going to be ready to start growing in the ground once I plant this in the ground. So let's get this guy planted up, and then I'll share with you guys my install of all the chiliplants.com plants that I got this year. So as you guys can see, I successfully got all my chiliplants.com plants planted out and had actually one extra row. Pretty much almost everything in the back row except for a few plants are actually plants from my local big box store. some of the Bonnie plants. And actually, I don't know if you guys could see this very well on the camera there, but all these guys, you know, they did have some challenges, some transplant shock going in. And, you know, I hit them with some pure protein, and now it looks like they're doing really well. They greened up. But as you guys can see, some of the Bonnie plants were not quite as resilient or healthy, in my opinion. Based on the fact that, you know, they just didn't bounce back as quickly, and actually some of them have some browning of the leaves that, you know, which means basically the plant's still under stress and not getting everything it needs. So I'm happy that all my chiliplants.com plants are doing well. I'm going to be growing actually a whole number of varieties this year because of them, and I'm really grateful, you know, and the work they're doing to preserve the genetic diversity. I cannot emphasize this enough. I mean, if you go down to your local nursery, you may be able to buy bell peppers. Bell peppers are probably one of the worst peppers, in my opinion. They're just grown for commercial trade because they get big, they have thick flesh, you know, they could be shipped fairly easily, they last a long time, you know, after they've been harvested. But they don't have a lot of flavor, man. People don't understand, like 500 varieties of different chilies from all ranges, from sweet to mild to a little bit hot to, you know, light your, you know what, on fire, you know. Chiliplants.com has it. So I want to go over actually some of the plants that I got this year here from the chiliplants.com. I got the HR, the Ahi Brown, the Ahi Cito, the Ahi Crystal, the Ahi Dulce One, the Ahi Habanero, Ahi Panica, Albino, Alma Paprika, Amazo, Ancho 101, Auntie Romanian, Bermuda Hot, Bishop's Crown, Bulldog, Hungarian Spice, Cherry Sweet, Chili Hybrid, Christmas Bell, Chupin Tinho, Korbasi, Czechoslovakian Black, Datil Sweet, Dito, Democa, Figaro, Fooled You Hybrid, Figatello, Fushimi, A Grenade of Seasoning, Havana, Lipstick, Little Dickens, Mayo, Pimento, PCR, Paprika, Peruvian Purple, Pillage, Puerto Rican, No Burn, Rocotillo, Rocoto Orange, Rocoto Red, Rocoto Yellow, Senorita Hybrid, Shishito, Smoking Edge, Carolina Reaper. We'll talk about more of that in a second. Sweet Pickle, Tangerine, Tequila Sunrise, Trinidad Perfume, Trinidad Smooth, Vietnamese Multicolor, Yellow Cheese, and the Yummy Orange. In addition, I also did get some tomatoes at the same time, since besides chilies, they also offer tomatoes and eggplants, and got some cool varieties of tomatoes that I just can't find locally unless I would have bought the seeds and had already started them, you know. I like getting a jump on the season, and if, you know, I don't start my seeds on time and I don't get to do that, because that's always the best way to do it. You're going to save the most money. It's going to be the least expensive. But I know a lot of people and you guys are busy, and you guys may have not even started your tomato seeds yet. If this is the case, I recommend you start at this point in time with the plants, because if you start by seed in most places of the country, depending on where you live, you're not going to get a good optimal bountiful harvest at this point. That's why I like, you know, ordering some plants. So the tomatoes we got some black cherries, which perform exceptionally well in my climate here that I've tested before. And the brown berry, coyote, Dr. Caroline, lollipop, Mexico midget, small fry, sugar cherry, sweet Chelsea, white currant. And I also got some eggplants, because eggplants, even better than peppers and tomatoes, they grow really well with very little care in the desert conditions. I got the Bride Hybrid, Casper, Cloud 9, Ghostbuster Hybrid, and Jade Sweet. Now I want to go over a few of the cool ones that I like. Number one, you know, chiliplants.com, they have so many different varieties of the peppers. And, you know, a lot of these varieties I've been researching for years and I've never been able to find them. So I'm glad that they're making them available, including many of the Aji, that one's A-G-I, Aji Ajicito, Aji Cristo, Aji Dulce, Aji Habanero, Aji Panica. I mean, all these are like rare South American peppers that are used in specific cuisines in South America to get that certain oomph, that flavor, right? And man, it's just like every different pepper has a different flavor profile, so I'm so excited to taste some of these peppers once they're fully ripe, grown in super rich, nutritious soil, so I get the maximum flavor out of them and also the maximum production. And I'll be having dried peppers freaking well into next year, so I'm quite happy about that. So besides the ajis, another pepper I really like are the Rocotos, the Rocoto Orange, Red, and Yellow. They have all different three varieties of Rocotos. The Rocotos are the most cold-tolerant peppers I've found. Does this mean you could grow them out in the winter? Absolutely not. Does this mean in an unheated greenhouse, like in the greenhouses that you see right there, I could grow them through the winter, even if it's, you know, 32 degrees out here? Absolutely, because I'm on a concrete pad and it's going to stay warm in there, and I even sprouted and grew tomatoes inside the greenhouses this winter. So I'm going to dig these guys up. They're actually right here, there, and there. And they're actually going to go in the greenhouse for the winter to continue to produce fruit for me, hopefully. And I'm probably going to, you know, cut them back, keep them a little bit small. So I like those guys a lot. Oh, another one, Smoking Ed's Carolina Reaper. That one's restricted. That one's actually, I don't know, some kind of trademarked or, you know, something, but what it is, it's the world's hottest pepper, guaranteed and verified by the Guinness Book of World Records at present time. It even smokes the Trinidad Scorpion Tea and the Buchalokis and all that, man. So if you want a seriously hot pepper, they got it here, Smoking Ed's Carolina Reaper. That's going to be fun. I'm going to make a pepper spray out of it, man. Burglar breaks in my house, he's getting some Smoking Ed's Carolina Reaper pepper spray in his face, man. All right. It's organic, so don't worry. All right, so anyways, on the tomatoes, I mostly got the cherry varieties, because the cherries produce more reliably in heat in excess of over 100 degrees from what I've found. Of course, some varieties are going to do better than others, so I got a nice variety to see which ones will do better than others. Of the ones on here, my favorite one for eating has to be definitely the coyote. The coyote is one of my favorite tasting tomatoes of all time. They're small little yellow ones, and they just, oh, they have an amazing flavor. Tastes kind of sweet, actually, not even like a tomato that you're used to. And then finally, we got some eggplants. Eggplants, easiest fruiting crop to grow in the desert in excess of 100 degrees. Even in 100 degree weather, they'll be actually, you know, flowering and fruiting and growing fruit with little water. And that could be important to some people also. And I've learned to love eggplant because I could grow it so well. So the eggplants I got are not just your standard, you know, purple round eggplants you could buy at the store, right? I got a whole selection, half dozen approximately, of white eggplants. So the white eggplants, they're gonna, number one, look cool, and number two, hopefully a few of them will actually even be sweeter than the standard purple ones that you may be used to. So yeah, definitely had a really good experience with the chiliplants.com. The last thing I want to tell you is that if you've never ordered plants in the mail, I definitely strongly encourage you to read their little instructions that they give you with each shipment and follow these to the T. I'm bad at reading directions, but everything still worked out for me. But I highly encourage you guys, if you haven't, you know, grown a lot of plants, don't have a lot of green thumbs or whatever, read these and follow them exactly. And, you know, they're there to help you out. Give them a call if you're having any challenges and whatnot. So I like this a lot. Last thing I'd like to say is that you can get a free catalog for chili plants. It's chiliplants.com. You can request their free catalog, which their catalog is good. I mean, if you're on the can or something, you need to read something. This is pretty cool. And they have some cool, you know, charts and stuff on how, you know, if it's medium hot and how big the peppers are and all this kind of stuff. But the main thing is it just has descriptions. And that's why, you know, like I was earlier in the video, I was on the website and you could see the pictures of the peppers. You could read about them. And they have a really great search tool, as I talked about earlier. So that's the best way you want to order the peppers. Order them online. Now, unfortunately, I don't have a special discount for my GYG viewers. But along with the order, I got this little card. It's a customer appreciation sale. And it said, we would like to thank you for your business. Any orders placed and received in June may take $1.50 off each plant. That's 40% off for you guys. So to get this special deal, it doesn't look like there's any code on there, but you just need to order 6 plants. So go there on June 1st, order your 6 plants, get some of these exotic chilies, grow them out, save your seeds so that you can spread and pass on some of this amazing genetic diversity that they're offering. I definitely want to encourage you guys to support, you know, local U.S. owned businesses and mom and pop shops like this is whenever you can, instead of the big box store. Although, you know, I got a fair number of plants at a local big box store because I think growing your own food is far better, you know, by any means you can, than buying food at the grocery store. I've really enjoyed the experience I had with chiliplants.com and would definitely recommend them to you guys. And once again, go there June 1st and save some money on their plants, 40%, and fill your plants with some peppers, tomatoes, and eggplants. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Once again, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time. And remember, keep on growing. All right, this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you, and this one's going to be a quick one at that. What we're going to do today is show you three easy, non-toxic